The fuck is a manga? Dog, are you coming to set? I'm about to fall over, right? We gotta shoot this right now.
Are you good?
No.
You're gonna roll your ankle.
What you did on set?
Why are you on roller skates?
No, wrong. It's not the same thing?
Well, you gotta be skating if you wanna do the interview.
Yeah, bro, we got a whole interview. What are you doing? Take them shits off.
Yeah, take them off. You're about to fall. You're about to get so broke.
A whole idiot.
Yo, you're tripping. No, hey, just take a seat.
Just fall.
Just fall.
Just fall.
Just do a front flip right now.
Do fall. It.
You won't do it. I know you won't.
Fact.
You know, it's probably easier.
You went too deep, bro. You got to do it right now.
Directing you.
Let's
it's
go.
All fun and games.
You got to move. You got to take one push. You got to take one step.
This man teaching you how to rollerblade.
Let's do it. Come on.
Mid-90s too.
Mid-90s too with roller skates?
Coming for you.
What's up, y'all? It's been a minute since you guys have seen us, but we're back in the conspiracy corner. Self Cal, homie Frazier's here, but as always, it's not about us at all. We've got the young god, Sonny Suljic, in here, star of mid-90s in theaters now. How are you doing, man?
Doing great. How about you?
I'm all right, man. Are you like, is it overwhelming? Like, what's it like stepping into...
He does not seem overwhelmed.
At all.
No, I am. That's how you know
you,
I'm overwhelmed, when I don't talk. When I do talk...
So usually you'd be a chatterbox, is that what you're saying?
Yeah! You know?
You didn't, because you get the crap kicked out of you for most of this movie. You're like literally running in the walls, getting pounded
I'm
on.
I'm constantly
literally
falling or getting beaten up.
The first shot is you getting slammed into a wall.
Yeah, it's one or the other. It's something crazy happened.
Were there, like, how much of
that's a big liability. The L word.
I just needed helmets and pads.
You're good though, you're not
hurt. Was that the longest scene to film?
No.
No?
No.
Really?
I don't remember. No, the longest scene to film, or felt like the longest scene to film, was the car crash.
Oh.
When we're, like, in that position. And I'm bad with blood.
Really?
No, but not actual blood. I actually rather have actual blood. I'd rather get broke and have blood than fake blood. I'm not playing.
Savage. I love it.
So you don't like wearing helmets. You'd rather bleed for real on set. Like, what else?
Oh, also, all the times that I peed, they were supposed to give me a water bottle, but I actually peed. That's another note.
That's amazing. This is like the most true-to-life film I've ever seen, though. Jesus. In seeing, you know, you talk about, you know, being on the promo run. I was watching you on Sneaker Shop, and shouts out to Joe LaPuma. What's your relationship with Jonah Hill like? It feels like a real...
It's the best relationship. People ask me if we're related. They're like, you guys don't look alike, but you guys are, like, really close.
He seems like the most lit big brother.
Facts.
100%.
Facts.
I don't feel like he's a director or anything. It's just he's a good friend.
That's
like
crazy.
A really good friend.
He's just a homie.
When you were on set, did you ever get a sense of like, oh, this is this guy's first movie, or did he just seem like a natural?
He was a natural. He was 100% natural. We were all taking a risk. I mean, it was like it was me, I was 11, and I was the lead role. Mm. And then it was his first time directing. And he also brought in people that have never acted before.
Yeah.
So we were all taking risks, so it was almost just like, it didn't even feel like we were shooting.
Yeah.
We were just like hanging out. We'd be skating when we weren't shooting. I would actually be skating.
Did you know, like, I'd known Nikhil from, you know, our future days and just seeing him skate. Did you know any of the guys that you worked with on the film before?
I didn't know them personally, but I knew of them. I mean, except Olin. I mean, Olin and I skate the same skate park. So I would like see him around, but I wouldn't really like interact with him. I wouldn't be like, it was good. I'd just be like, I was just memorized. What the fuck did I just say? What did I just say?
You said memorize, but I know
what
you meant.
No, not memorize. Mesmerize.
Yes.
Wow. I mean, just stop talking.
Well, they always make fun of me for saying big words.
I can't say big words. He said laconic a couple of days ago. I still don't know what you were talking about.
I can't say big words. Every time I try to say remorse, I say remember, and...
I respect it.
It's crazy.
What happens.
Yeah, I think big words are just not for me. They're just not for some people. You know?
I think you're still like in the big words grade, though. Like, you're good.
Yeah.
I mean, or he's just like, you know what? I'm not worrying about these big words.
You're just not ready for
AK. Facts, like, why?
No, I want to have the big words, though. I'd rather say, like, two words instead of, like, a full paragraph.
That's this man. I imagine you might be getting tired of questions like this, but I have to wonder, did the 90s seem boring as hell to you? Like,
No.
No? Liked it?
Do you wish you were born in the 90s, having done this movie?
I don't wish, because when everyone thinks that they're like, oh, I wish I was born in the 90s, the 80s. They just think about the positive stuff.
Mm.
But then there's also
That's a deep
More thing. Racism. There's a bunch of stuff that's happening. So right now, I'm not complaining where I'm at in right now. And I'm on Complex right now.
There is
crazy
no complex
cameras. Gang, gang. There's no Complex. I like the 90s. Mm. I got to explore the 90s in a period of 6 weeks and the good parts of the 90s. Yeah. So I already relived it.
That's awesome. Because it's like, I remember the things that stuck out to me the most was like you in the beginning of the film, just like looking over shoes and literally like sitting there looking at a album liner notes. Like, that's an experience I had that I know kids growing up today, like, is that something you've ever done before? Just like sitting looking through a book about an album that you're listening to?
No one even has CDs.
I don't recall. I've probably done it, but yeah.
It's not a pastime.
Did you keep any like cool 90s props from the set?
All the jeans.
Yeah?
I got all the jeans.
Oh, that's fire.
Because I was just like, that's like, whoa, these jeans vintage are so hard.
Yeah.
So I just got all of them.
That's what kids are trying to cop now, so you just got them for free.
Yeah, I got all of them for free. And it's so hard to, like, it's super hard to find, especially in my size. I
mean,
It was the Levi's, the Ralph Lauren's.
Word.
Yeah, I got the fits.
Damn.
He's got the fits.
I got the fits.
And the cakes after sneaker shopping.
Oh, yep, you already know.
All right, so the movie's out nationwide now. Have you been like sneaking into theaters and just like watching
people? No, my friends are like, hey, let's go watch a movie. I'm like, why would someone go to their own theater? Like, probably my two reasonings would be like, he wants recognition and I've already seen it a lot of times. I think it's just hella weird. Yeah. I would not do that.
That makes sense.
Like, you'd be, I mean, if you do that, that's all you. But I mean, I think I'd be pretty arrogant. See, that was a big word.
Now,
see?
I respect
there
that.
We go. Let's
give it up for Sonny.
Arrogant.
Hashtag education.
So you're in Sacred Deer, you're in mid-90s. Are you like only into doing adult content now? Like, are we only going after Oscar movies?
I'm down to do anything. If the script is good, if it's not corny, if it's not corny, then I'm down to do it. I mean, I'm definitely very picky. I won't just accept everything that I get because the bag's there.
Yeah.
So I'd rather just be patient. And
no bag thirst.
Yeah, no bag thirst. Because the bag thirst comes after you know what you're doing, you know what I mean?
Right.
Because you can get a bag and it just fucks up your whole career and then you're done. Mm. Or you could just be patient and then it slowly comes and then you just get more later on.
Damn.
You
got knowledge.
I got the knowledge, bro. I got the knowledge when the bag comes, you know?
I respect
it. If it involves the bag, I know what I'm talking about.
What do you get into outside of acting and skating?
Fortnite.
Whoa.
But that's it. Like, yeah, I'm skating, acting. I skate every single day, and then when I come home, I play Fortnite until like 3 a.m.
Word.
And then, unfortunately, school sometimes.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
And then acting
school
again.
School's unfortunate.
So I think those are the main three things.
You skate while you're on like promo tours as well?
Yeah, I bring my board.
Where, like, are you just?
This is the only time that I bring my board.
And we got no board here?
No board.
There's a board, but it has no wheels on it somewhere around here. Do we want to talk about some of this old shit and see, you know, what my man's knows? Do they teach you how to cursive write these days? Like, do you know about cursive writing?
You know, they stopped that.
Yeah, what? That's what I'm saying. Like,
I don't know why. That's so stupid. Because it also helps your signature, too.
Facts.
When you're older.
I wonder, like...
My signature's horrible.
Mine is trash. Mine used to be good, but the more you don't use it, the more... Like, even my handwriting is trash.
Yeah, no. I don't... Yeah, they don't do signature anymore. I'm so heated that they don't do that. I fortunately got to learn cursive. Yes.
Word. You might have been like the last group of kids actually doing cursive. Because I think like if a kid coming up in like second or third grade now, it's probably dead.
Oh yeah, they don't even learn about like states anymore. Like
what?
Kids
out here with no geography.
No geography. I mean, they talk about like present. Like I'm. Actually, don't listen to me. But I think I know that. Don't listen to me. No one listen to me. This whole interview, don't listen to any word I'm saying.
I mean, if they do, we'll never know. I'm too old to know this stuff anyway.
No states?
That'd be lit.
That's what my homie was telling me, but his school just might be trash. I don't know.
Don't go to trash
school. What grade are you in now?
Eighth.
Damn. I remember that time.
What else was I doing in eighth grade?
What were you doing in eighth grade? You were probably watching Buffy or something. He's not doing
OC. The OC was popping. You know what the OC is? Next time you see Jonah, ask him about the OC. If he doesn't say classic, he's bugging. Classic.
So you play Fortnite. Do you play any like the skate video games?
I played Skate 3. I had Skate 2 and Skate 3.
Mm.
I always used to play that, but then I realized that I wasn't good at it, so I got bummed and started playing Black Ops. When I started playing Black Ops, Fortnite came out, and I was like, oh, because Black Ops I wasn't even that good at. But then with Fortnite, I got the build-ems, bro. Yeah. I got the build-ems.
That's the move. It's not just being able to work a person. You got to be able to build
those shit. A lot of my friends are like, bro, I was never good at... It's almost like a sobbing story. They're like, I was never good at video games. Then Fortnite came along. Because you have to have a lot of strategy.
Word. That's why I'm terrible at it.
Yeah, you have to have a lot of patience. And you have to put a lot of thought into it.
Mm-hmm. They just dropped a new one of that, too. Do you have like a squad that you play with on Fortnite?
Yeah, I got a squad.
Word? Is like your skate buddies just like totally different squad?
No. 100% squatted. Like, I'm squatted up. Word. We skate, and then we go home, and it's like, all right, I'll see you in Fortnite.
Damn. That's the life. That's the actual life.
It's the best life. It's the best life. You just skate, and then you come home, squatted up.
You're living it right now. I mean
you got it figured out.
Thank you for coming through. Greatly appreciate it. Again, if y'all haven't seen Mid-90s yet,
go check it out.
See it.
You're bugging.
Who hasn't seen Mid-90s yet?
I mean.
What are you doing?
You gotta do it right now.
You won't see him in the theater anymore, but go see it. It's great. Thank you for coming through, Sonny.
Thank you so
appreciate much. Appreciate it. Let us know what you thought about this in the comments down below. You can hate on us, but please don't hate on Sonny. But if you do, he might find y'all on Fortnite and take y'all out.
He's gonna send the squad out.
Oh yeah, we playing Playground, 1v1.
Big facts, yep. Big facts. All right, Conspiracy Corner out.